Hello and welcome to Success from Anywhere at Salesforce, a new video series where I will talk to people around the world about success from anywhere. In this video, we're going to talk about how to use Slack to build better remote teams. I'm going to let Nikki Nolan introduce themselves.
Awesome. So I'm Nikki Nolan. I go by she, her, sometimes she, they, who knows, you know, it depends on the day. And I am a product designer, senior product designer here at Slack. And I design the help and education for our tool. Yeah.
Wow. You know, I love that you just introduced yourself and included your pronouns. I'm going to begin to do that. Start again. Hi, my name is Essence Royal and I go by she, her. All right, so great. And I appreciate you for joining us. So I'm looking forward to today's discussion. With that, let's kick it off with our first question. Nikki, for those who don't know about Slack, help them understand. What can you tell them about Slack?
Well, Slack is amazing. Slack has like changed my work life completely. It's especially awesome because it has a mobile app, which makes it so if I have to run out and do something urgently, I can still stay connected to people. And like, I just never feel out of the loop and I can return to it. So we love to use this word asynchronously. And so what's really amazing about Slack is that I can say something, come back to it later and get a bunch of information. And it doesn't have to be so, oh, you're online, I'm online, we have to talk about it. It's really wonderful. And I love that I can like update people when I'm on the go, and it makes communication so much easier, like significantly easier. It makes it more pleasant. It makes it so much more pleasant.
I can absolutely concur with that. I don't understand how everyone isn't using this. Like, it definitely helps me throughout my entire day and I'm always in Slack. So I appreciate that. So tell me this, how do you include Slack in your daily life?
I think the easier question is how is it not included in my daily life? Because I feel like it's intertwined to everything I do. And I don't know, I use it for, you know, work, but I also have used it for like groups and stuff like that are around work topics. So I have different Slacks that help me keep connected. I have a book club Slack, you know, where we talk about budgeting, you know, and it really has. I don't know what my life was like before Slack was in my life, but I'm constantly on it. I'm checking in with my team. I'm checking in with like individual people that I'm working with. I check in to see, you know, what's the best meme, you know? It just like, it makes life so much more delightful.
I concur. My whole, like all of our teams are using Slack. I don't know what did we use before then? Doesn't matter. Slack is it. Slack is the move. So tell me, how do you remain flexible when using Slack?
Like when life happens, you know, we're in calendar year 3 of a pandemic and life needs to be more flexible. And Slack really helps me not only do my job, but also be able to live my life. And I think that is really important, trying to figure out how to have this really nice work-life balance where you're still connected to your team, you're still doing your job, but you're able to do it from a more flexible environment. So it helps because I can like grab my phone and, you know, go out and run some errands, you know, maybe pick up some food from the grocery store and still be like in communication with people.
So it definitely helps you keep a good bond with your team. Tell me about those bonds that you've built like over Slack.
So I communicate a lot through GIFs and like GIFs and emojis. And I think that, I don't know, I feel like I didn't have that relationship to work until I got Slack, where I feel like I can express myself so much better if I just throw a GIF in it, or if I just like react to something with an emoji that is just expressing how I feel without the words that I can say. It just keeps it really, really fun. I also used to be on our design culture team and we would create weekly activities inside of our Slack. And I think that's actually really important for building communities, making sure you have this weekly ritual. Make sure that you have things that it's not just about work, it's also about enjoyment and making sure, you know, we're all people. And why does work have to be painful? Why can't work be fun? Why can't we enjoy work? And I think that Slack, you know, helps us bond more. It helps us enjoy work more. Like, you know, it just keeps us all connected and we get to learn from each other. To take it a little bit back, it's a little bit different than how we bond. But what's really nice about Slack is that it is like an index to everything that's ever happened. If your team is on it, you can go and you can search, you can figure out how decisions were made. It really gives you this transparency into things that I find helps me understand people better without even actually having to talk to them sometimes.
Man, when you said that you love GIFs, I call them GIFs. Isn't that crazy? But,
no.
But if people don't use emojis, I'm like, you're questionable. You know, I use emojis.
So good.
All right, so let's talk about leveraging those bonds and how you build a stronger team.
So yeah, so I sort of touched on it before, but I feel like Slack is the water cooler. It's the place where you go, you get like the information, but you also bond. And so like everything happens in Slack at Slack. And I've learned so much working at the company that I didn't do at other companies. And I think it's really important for people to not only see Slack as like, it's not just for like the day-to-day backend stuff. It's for everything. It's for planning events. It's for every single aspect of work can be done in Slack. And I just feel like I could be like, you know, more authentic inside of Slack than I was pre-Slack. I feel like I was really uptight. I also feel like I used to wear suits. I don't know how come, but I feel like I used to wear lady suits a lot, and not that it needs to be a gender, but I, but you know, leveraging those bonds, I'm able to connect better with my colleagues. I'm able to work quicker and I'm able to like, you know, it feels more casual. And so I'm able to feel more connected to people. It's really nice.
I can feel that. You know, I think about like emails, and to me, emails are like dead, because there's if I look in my email, I probably have like 3,000 unread messages, but I am going to answer a Slack message like instantly.
I have 46,000 unanswered emails. I just looked down. Oh my god.
And it terrifies me to even be thinking about going to like look through those messages. But if someone sends me a Slack, I'm on it. What does it feel like to have a Slack first mindset? What does that mean to you?
Yeah, so a Slack first mindset is like, it is where I go to work. Like, do I need to find a document? Do I need to learn about a project? Do I need to organize an event? Slack is like the place to do everything. And it works really well with our app team is doing amazing work there to make sure that, you know, Slack is the place that you can do all the work. You don't have to kick off and go to like another application. Like I can file tickets with Jira just like inside Slack. I can respond to a comment in a document in Slack. I don't have to leave it. And so Slack is the place. It is the place that I go, that I don't have to jump around to all the places. I really can go to Slack and just focus.
That's so real. So as recruiters, I'm an equality talent partner here, but we have a team of like 200 recruiters. And let's say I can't use a candidate for my specific jobs. I'll put them in a Slack group. It's called SalesRad. I'll put it in the Slack group. Hey, this candidate has this background, X, Y, and Z. And like 200 recruiters are like, I want them. I got them. I'll take them. And the candidate has more access to all of us in that much time.
What you just said was amazing. I do think that Slack gives you access. Like it tears down the walls, it tears down the borders, it tears down all of the things that make work more complicated. I just wanted to thank you for naming that.
Good. I think the recruiters will be happy we mentioned them. For those of you who tuned in, thank you so much for joining us today. If you're interested in learning more about life here at Salesforce, please visit us at salesforce.com/careers. Also, if you'd like to watch another video where I talk to another amazing colleague of mine, just click that video on the screen. Thanks again for watching.